Introduction to trigonometry. Trigonometric identities. So basically we have three identities over here. Let me write down all the three identities first. Now your first identity is, so your first identity is sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Now let us see how does this identity exactly come into existence. For that I need a right angle triangle. So let us assume this is a right angle triangle. Let me name the vertices of this right angle triangle. Say this right angle triangle is ABC. Now it has three sides, AB, BC and AC. As we already know, we can see that angle B over here is 90 degree. So we can apply trigonometry over here. Let me consider three sides of the triangle, say AB be equal to 5 units. Let this BC be equal to say 12 units. And let the third side, that is the hypotenuse side, be equal to 13 units. So we have all the three sides of the triangle, AB is equal to 5, BC is equal to 12 and AC is equal to 13. Now if you apply this identity properly, sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1, you can see over here. Let us try to prove it, whether it is true or not. We know that the sine theta is opposite upon hypotenuse. It is opposite upon hypotenuse. So for that, first of all, I need to identify this angle theta. What I'm doing is, I'm considering this acute angle C as say angle theta. So this identity is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1 sine theta. So let me consider this angle C as theta over here. Now for this theta, what I'll do is I'll consider the opposite side, which is the side exactly in front of theta. That is the opposite side, which we have already seen in the previous slides as well. So this side AB is the opposite side. That means I have this 5 as my opposite side. Whereas this H stands for hypotenuse. So hypotenuse is what? It is the side opposite to 90 degrees. So 90 degrees over here and side opposite to 90 degrees here. So I'll have this part as my hypotenuse. So I have O upon H. O upon H is nothing but, I can move further, O is AB. So I have this O as AB. And I have this H, hypotenuse is AC. So let me write down AC over here. So I have AB upon AC, but we know the values. The value of AB over here is 5. So this is 5. And we have the value of AC. AC value is 13. So let me write down 13. So we got the first value. That is, we got the value of sine theta. Sine theta is 5 upon 13. Now let me move on to this cos theta. So for cos theta, we already know that cos theta is given by adjacent upon hypotenuse. It is adjacent divided by hypotenuse. Again, we have this. Again, we have seen this in the trigonometric ratios as well. So A upon H. Now, our theta is over here. We had identified that the opposite side is AB. The hypotenuse side is AC. So which is the side remaining? The only side remaining over here is this BC. And this for theta, this BC is nothing but the adjacent side. That means my 12 is BC will be adjacent. So let me write down A upon H. So we have A as BC. And then we have our H, that is hypotenuse, as AC, which is fixed. And then we have BC upon AC. So how much is BC? BC is 12. And then AC is 13. You can see in the last, you can see in sine theta as well, the value of H, that is 13. So basically we got two values. The two values are 5 upon 13, which is of sine theta, and we got the value of cos theta. Cos theta is 12 upon 13. Now what I can do is, instead of sine theta over here, I can put 5 upon 13, and instead of cos theta over here, I can put 12 upon 13. Let me see what do I get. So sine theta is 5 upon 13. Cos theta is 12 upon 13. So let me just substitute the value of sine theta, as we know, 5 upon 13. This is 5 upon 13. The whole square. Why whole square? Because we are already having a square term over here. Sine square. So 5 upon 13 square plus cos theta is 12 upon 13. Let me write down 12 upon 13 over here. So I get 12 divided by 13. Again, I'll get a whole square over here because it is cos square theta. Cos square theta. Square is there. Okay. So, what answer should I get to verify? I should get 1. So, let me check whether I'm getting 1 or not. So, the next step what I can do is, I can square both the terms. 5 square, it is going to give me 25. 5 square is going to give me 25. And 13 square is going to give me 169. Plus we have 12 square. 12 square is going to give me 144. And 13 square is going to give me 169. If I move on further, what do I get? I get this 169 as the common denominator. So let me write down 169 once. There is addition, so add these two terms. So 25 plus 144, that is going to give me 169 again. And then I have 169 in the denominator as well. So 169, 169 gets cancelled. And ultimately, we are going to get the value as 1. You can see here clearly. We get the RHS as 1. So this is our first identity, that is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Similar to this identity, we have two more identities as well. The identity that we saw right now was sin square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1. This was our first identity. The two more identities are 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. 1 plus tan square theta equals to sec square theta. This is the second identity, and we have one more identity, that is 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. So these are the three identities that we are having. These are very three important identities which we are going to use while solving these sums.